Hey, of course we're all in the same boat, and I want to talk to you this morning in Alabama about the concerns that I have about redistricting. And while I'm not in charge or a decision-making figure in any capacity, I am a dedicated tax-paying citizen that is worried about the next decade and it being anything like the last decade in Alabama. So I want to talk to you, just candid, me to you. You know, America views 2016 as our nation's beginning to the end of much. I view the same for Alabama going back to 2010. Seems to me that winning at all costs in Alabama has disrupted a moral code like we have never seen anyway. And each time I go back to dissect when the corruption and the awful injustices that have occurred in this state began, I begin to reflect on the best times of my life in this state under Don Siegelman's leadership as governor. You know, it wasn't just a time of Democratic majority. It was a time when most politicians and legislative leaders aspired to do what was best by Alabama. I remember the conversations across the aisle, and I recall my own on the porch with a glass of sweet tea, respectfully disagreeing with neighbors, but still conversing over ways and creative ideas of compromising. It's been a very long time since people in legislation roles saw their constituents or heard them and believed in the people that put them there. For me, I get my wisdom from the people that I speak with. I find my solutions in the problems they face. So I thought maybe I would share with you, as a candidate who is also aspiring to reach all the voters that have the power to send me to Montgomery, how I feel about what is happening down there among our leaders in charge right now. First of all, I'm embarrassed and I'm ashamed of them and what's happening. I'm saddened by their lack of conviction to know their decisions and motives are overseen by a much bigger judge than me. And you know, they're going to be called out, if not in this life, the next. And that worries me that they believe that they live in a safe zone because this is politics. You know, their Bible tells me much is required by those given much, and that they have sinned when they willingly know that something is wrong and they choose to do it anyway. There's been a lot of wrong with many things in our state, and yet no one wants to talk about the elephant in the room. People want to win at all costs. The dark money, our root of all this evil, has corrupted their judgment and has removed their aspirations to serve all of Alabama. I don't understand why a state of abundance cannot share the wealth and do right by all citizens. I cannot believe a card-carrying Christian can truly believe that they have superiority over any race, gender, status, or individual. If Jesus himself was willing to come to this earth by way of a manger in a stable, why would we think that we're exempt from the mistreatment of others? So let me just be candid here, okay? I have no filter. This is what I do. But the reapportionment process to me was a disgrace. It still is. It's the epitome of being appointed to the least qualified kids in a class, having to work together for a science project that will make up half of their grades. Their dependency on a good grade and its success is left with the reliance of others. Alabamians depend on the decisions being made for them for the next decade to be done with the most due diligence possible. Yet we witnessed a room full of seasoned legislators who have had months to prepare. Yeah, I get that they just got the documents, but they've known about this. They had time to learn and understand the environment, the law, the software, the boundaries, talk to one another, bring tools and resources into the room to make it the best science project of their lives. And yet, not one walked into the room prepared to discuss the lives of many. In 10 years, Many will graduate high school without the same opportunity as many others because of these decisions. Over the next 10 years, more hospitals will probably close, less people will be insured, more jobs will open in metro areas, less people will remain in their hometowns in the rural areas for lack of jobs. More people will drop out of school, less people will graduate with honors, more kids will move out of state, more taxes will be implemented, less transparency will be available. The list goes on and on and on and on. Yeah, all we see is black and white issues, I get that, but it goes much deeper than that. Men spoke over women, dismissed their concerns. Questions weren't answered. The ones who could answer them was not present. The data wasn't provided. The concern was not there. The comprehension of what is at stake was dismissed. The urgency to rush through the process was disappointing. The lack of inclusion for the voters that it will affect was wrong. The feeling of mistrust for our leaders was growing, and the facts and the figures were not accurate. The discussions were vague. The priorities were not those of liaisons standing in the gap for those that they were elected to represent. Overall, it has been an undermining, mistrusting, overstated misrepresentation of leaders looking out for all people, in my opinion. And it made me sick to watch. You know, those majority of men in that room, they had no solutions. There was a few women that suggested a couple things that I thought were great, and they did try to speak up, but they were dismissed and spoken over as though they were irrelevant to the conversation and that their voice didn't matter to the conversation. It was so disgraceful, a disappointment, and it was calculated from the word go. It left me with the feeling that either they were all in on a decision that was already pre-made, and this was just a show to appease to us, like kind of like the hearings, a preliminary that they just put out there to satisfy us. Or it's a group of incompetent people that have no idea the cost of their decisions and how heavily burdening this responsibility was. Why we do not have government oversight in the country's worst gerrymandering state in the nation, and why we do not have independent commissions overseeing this endeavor is mind-boggling. To say the least, it is unbelievably upsetting to know that a Bible Belt state like ours, that is supposed to align with their Christian values and is made up of supposedly Christian men, would even allow a policy in place to insist one rule they must abide by, and that's to not cut out any current incumbents that could lose their respective seats and ensure that they're protected and their own self-interest come first. When I heard that being said by the chairman himself, I knew these were not leaders that I could say represent me. They are self-serving, uneducated, disconnected, opportunists that have done nothing in the last decade to make our lives better. We're not richer, smarter, or healthier under their leadership. And come 2022, I hope with every fiber in me that every one of you do your due diligence and pay forward your contribution to change. Because I do not believe that Alabama has the sustainability to endure another 10 years under this current administration in Alabama. And I mean that with every piece of conviction in my heart. Please step up. Pay attention. Don't sit back and let someone else do it for you. The cavalry isn't coming. Our parties are not going to save us. We are people first, citizens of a state that is asking a lot out of us. Hold them accountable. Make them listen, or make them go home. This state is made up of more of us than them, but someone has forgotten to remind them of that. And that's all I'm going to say about it for now. But know this, for all of the hundreds of people reaching out, asking for help, direction, and information? I don't know much more than you do. And I certainly don't have the microphone to scream louder than you do. But you can know inside that I am screaming from the top of my lungs and scratching the epidural layer of my skin off my head in disbelief and wonder what on earth we are doing in this state to selectively hurt people and let them struggle. I'm in awe too. But we got to hang in there. We've got to keep fighting. The alternative is not an option. We are crossing county lines, and we will be there soon too if we can. I'm Lisa Ward, and I am running for state senate, but I'm coming to you as a citizen of Alabama first.